Today's Spotlight is brought to you in part by presenting sponsor, Busey Bank. Busey, your dream, our promise.
You're watching Spotlight, and today I'm joined by Linda and Kim from Nick's Network of Hope. So welcome to the set.
Thank you very much.
I'm interested very much to hear this story because I know it's a very powerful message, and it's something that we're talking a lot about in our society right now. So I'm going to start right off with you, Linda. Talk a little bit about Nick's Network of Hope.
All right. Nick's Network of Hope was formed in 2013 after we lost our son, Nicholas. Nick was a freshman at the University of Minnesota, and he was just about ready to finish that first year of college, and he took his own life. People can learn more about Nick's story by going on our website, nicksnetworkofhope.org. Also, I'm writing a book that will talk more in depth about Nick's story, as well as my journey as a suicide survivor and my family's journey. I think, Jane, that it will really resonate with people because, you know, we're all going through stuff. And even though the book talks about meaty topics, it's a story of hope and it's a story of faith. But they can look for it on our website. The website itself was formed in 2016, and it covers suicide, depression, anxiety, LGBTQ, eating disorders, substance abuse, addiction, cutting, and self-harm. What's unique about our website is that it covers all those life challenges in one site. And that's important because people often go through or have one disorder and it overlaps with another disorder. So, for example, you can have an eating disorder and suffer from an anxiety. Or you can be a member of the LGBTQ community and have a substance abuse addiction problem. It's just good to have it all in one place. The website, even though it is all covered in one site, it is categorized beautifully so that it's user-friendly, and it's each category has a learn page and a get help page. So it's set up so that if somebody is looking for something, they can quickly find it and get off the website, or they can go on and keep on hitting links that will take them to different national organizations and go further and further into research. We have an extensive resource page with just tons of resources, links to all, like I said, national organizations and local organizations. There is the suicide prevention hotline number on every page because when you are going through a crisis, that's really important. The website is very uplifting. We wanted it to be something that was bright, that gave inspiration to people, that gave them hope. People would benefit if they just wrote it down on a piece of paper, nicksnetworkofhope.org, and put it in their wallet. If they're out and about and somebody comes up to them and says that they're going through something or they know somebody that's going through some problems, it is a wonderful way of reaching out to them. You can just hand them the website and it opens up the door to all kinds of resources for them. At the very least, it shows that you care. And at the most, it could actually save a life. And we actually know that our website has saved a life already. Right?
We had, through some of the outreach, a young woman had some of our cards and she had them in her desk. And she went to work and she was just doing, you know, social media. And then on social media, she noticed that one of her friends, good friend, that had suffered from severe depression in the past and had really struggled, had posted on Facebook that he was, you know, really struggling and wanted to end his life. She couldn't leave. So she took a picture of the card, sent it to him. He went on the site and he found something on the site that gave him hope. And he stayed. And through our continual outreach and follow-up, we found that he's got two jobs. He's living on his own, and he's doing great. So that's one life that Linda has touched. We've touched through that.
That's wonderful. Well, I know I have been on the website, and as you very clearly laid out, it's very user-friendly. Nick's story is sad and inspiring. both in the same, you know, as a mother of children, it really does resonate with you. But I think the thing that you talked about with the whole life challenges, and I liked the way that you talked about that, because challenges can be short-term and they can be long-term. But you're really about resources, giving people resources and a little bit of control that they can get in touch with things that could help them with those life challenges.
Absolutely.
Right?
Absolutely.
Yeah.
Yep.
Kim, how did you come to get involved in Nick's network?
I had heard about Linda's son, and of course my heart went out to her. Our family has been touched by suicide as well. And I know that I know parents and I know my kids' friends who have really struggled as well. And I just think it's an important issue for this community and every community. So when I heard that she was doing, we actually talked at a party, and when I heard she was doing it, I just said, let me help. I wanted to be involved.
Yeah. I think it's so funny. We talk a little bit about, you know, social media and it's all the socialness, but it's really, we're finding ourselves in times that are very isolated. And I think our young people are finding it hard to stay connected, and where do they go and how do they have those relationships and stuff, because it seems on a very superficial level at this point, maybe not so much relationship based. What are your goals, Linda? I mean, obviously you've taken tremendous personal tragedy and turned that into something that you're really trying to have a powerful impact on others. Where do you see Nick's Network for Hope going?
Well, we would love to do public speaking, to go into churches, to go into schools, VFW halls, anybody who would have us. We'd be more than willing to go out and just talk to people. If we can lessen the burden anybody is going through, or talk to suicide survivors and help them get through their journey, we're in. We're all in for that.
Okay. Kim, I know you've been involved a lot, so what do you see as well?
This is just going to be a natural extension of that. Just being here and the books that she's writing, we're definitely going to get out there more. I'd like to see a greater presence on social media.
Yeah.
Just to be a beacon of light out there, which can be great and it can be not so great, especially for young people. So that's what I'd like to see.
Okay. And Linda, you've recently talked with NAMI, right?
Yes. Yes. They've asked me to be a public speaker, and they want me to tell my journey as a suicide survivor. Yeah. And as part of that, one of the things that kept me going, that helped me on a soul level to keep waking up in the morning and keep on fighting through, was to go out and help people and to form this charity. So through my talking with NAMI, we'll also be having some exposure to Nick's Network of Hope and getting the word out to people.
Well, I think that's it's such an important part, is being able to share. And certainly when one hears your story, they hear Nick's story, you know, you can't help but find that empathy and that understanding and try to think about how could you be of assistance. And it could be the teenage kid that just came in and out of your house yesterday. It could be somebody that you see at work, you know, so it touches so many lives.
Oh, and Jane, that's the one thing I learned, is that it could happen to anybody.
Yeah.
It happens to, we're all affected in the community.
Yeah.
Linda's been really wonderful about reaching out to other parents who are going through this and working to help them. And that's a very hard thing for someone who's grieving to do. And I just wanted to give you that, because it's important.
Yeah, absolutely. Well, I thank you. I thank you for the courage of coming on and sharing your story. I wish you hope for Nick's Network of Hope, that it really continues to touch people and clearly save lives. So thank you.
And when I get done writing the book and it's published, I would love to come back and talk about it.
Please do. We would love that.
Thank you.
If you would like to learn more about Nick's Network of Hope and how you can help them raise awareness and provide resources and education to support suicide prevention efforts, please go and visit their website. We're going to take a quick break, but stay with us. We're coming right back with more Spotlight.